So key challenges that engineers are facing now in the oil and gas industry from the conversations we have. Some of these are related to process changes. So switching to different feedstocks or different chemical compositions in your process, which then adds an uncertainty into the corrosion rates you can expect to see in an asset. So where you might have been operating for many years with a stable environment with predictable corrosion rates, when you introduce a new chemical to that environment or a new process from a feedstock, that can have a dramatic effect on those corrosion rates. And zones of the facility where previously you didn't see any metal wastage, you can suddenly have pitting corrosion that can lead to risks of loss of containment, major issues or accidents relatively quickly. So managing those risks proactively in advance of the change in the process is key by using methods to enhance or upgrade those pieces of equipment to cope with their new environments. Environmental legislation is a risk. Assets run the risk of being shut down if they're seen to be in breach of their environmental requirements. So maintaining vigilance in terms of monitoring that, but also finding ways to reduce that impact and being able to demonstrate that to your environmental authority are key. Aging equipment is always a concern. Over time, equipment becomes more susceptible to risks. That can be because of repeat mechanical work, maintenance, you know, repeated welding in certain zones or alterations to the equipment. It can be due to, over time, the loss of that corrosion allowance that was originally installed. So aging equipment is always critical, when particularly when you're looking at the repurposing or revamping of an asset. You want to extend that design life another 10, 15 years. Additional complication we see in the market is the availability of the raw materials to do that. So we've heard of very long lead times for purchasing of new equipment, and also the difficulty and the cost of obtaining corrosion resistant alloys to install in that equipment from new to then put it into the facility. So having a technology which you can use brownfield in situ to upgrade that equipment without the requirement for replacement can save a lot of costs and also a lot of headache for facilities when considering asset integrity.